Mawa or khoya is the base for many Indian sweets. While the traditional way of making mawa is long and labor-intensive, from now on, you can make it in a jiffy. Wondering how? Let me show you. In a heated non-stick kadhai, I am putting 2 tablespoons of desi ghee. Into this, adding 1/2 cup milk. Let the mixture heat until it comes to a good boil. Once it does, add 1 cup of full cream milk powder. Just make sure to keep on stirring as you add the milk powder in batches. This is to avoid the lumps. Even after you have added all the powder, keep on stirring the mixture. Since milk powder is the main ingredient here, I recommend using the finest quality milk powder available to you. Take note, this entire process is happening on low flame. We will cook this until the moisture evaporates. Eventually, you will see the mixture thickening up. In a span of 4 to 5 minutes, the mixture will start leaving the sides of the pan and solidify like a dough, as compared to the traditional process that takes around 40 minutes to an hour. Here your mawa is almost ready in just 5 minutes. Take it off the flame. Set it in a clean container while still warm. Store-bought mawa is pricey and sometimes even adulterated. Why not make it at home when you can so easily? We will let this cool at room temperature. Once it cools down, what you get is the perfect crumbly homemade mawa or khoya ready to use. You can store it in the refrigerator and this stays good for 3 to 4 days in an airtight container. Grate or crumble as needed. Enjoy making mawa barfi, mawa paratha or gujia. Whatever you make, rest assured, it will turn out rich and soulful just like anything you make with love. Well, don't you forget to love yourself too. As I always say, eat well, live well, and stay blessed.